This is Kim Herron with your devotion taken from 1 Samuel chapter 1. Have you ever had a time in your life where you just wanted to pour your heart out to God because you were so distressed over a matter? Or maybe it was that you were so burdened down by it that people began to notice that something was different about you and began to ask, are you okay, or something along that line? That's kind of what happened here in 1 Samuel chapter 1. There are three key players that are mentioned to open up the chapter. First of all, there's the man, Elkanah, and he had two wives. One of them was Hannah, and the other one was named Peninnah. Now, Peninnah was able to have children. She had multiple children, the Bible tells us, both girls and boys. However, Hannah was barren, the Bible said, and was not able to have any children. Now, Elkanah loved Hannah more. And unfortunately, in biblical days, it was acceptable to society to be able to have multiple wives, but that created some complexities of its own. And so it was in this situation, because as time would go along, Peninnah would torment, or what we might call today, bully Hannah because she had no children. She would rub it in her face or pour salt in the wound, whatever phrase you want to use. She was tormenting Hannah over the fact that she had no children. This drove Hannah to the point that she was very distressed, and she went to the Lord in the temple, and we might say that she went to the church house, and she prayed unto the Lord. In fact, in verse 10, it says, in the bitterness of soul, Hannah wept much and prayed to the Lord. That's how distressed she was, because she wanted to have a baby so bad, which was natural in that time, because if you were a woman that was married and of childbearing years and you had no children, people would look upon you as though you were cursed by God, or you had done something wrong that God would not allow you to have children. Now, we know that that is, you know, not the case as far as the perception that was given, but in reality, humanity can be cruel to humanity, and that's what they did in those days, and they thought that she was under the curse of God. And so as it goes on, it says that in her state of bitterness, she went to the temple, or we'd say she went to the church, and she prayed to the Lord. Now, the Bible says in that state, she made a vow unto the Lord. And the vow that she made to the Lord was that if God would allow her to have a child, that she would dedicate that child, that male child, unto the Lord, and that he would become a Nazarite, and that he would serve the Lord for the rest of his life. Now, the Bible tells us in Numbers 30 and 2, if a man vows to vow to the Lord or swears an oath to bind himself by a pledge, he shall not break his word. He shall do according to all that proceeds out of his mouth. This is exactly how much that she was distressed, that she was willing to make that vow to the Lord, knowing that the expectation was that if God granted her wish, if God granted her prayer, then that child would forever be dedicated unto the Lord. We find that as she prayed, Eli the priest, or we call him the preacher today, saw her, and he thought that she was drunk. But the Bible says in Ephesians 5 and 18, and be not drunk with wine when in excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Hannah was praying to the Lord out of her great distress, to the point that it appeared to those on the outside that she might even be drunk with alcohol, because she was praying and her mouth was moving, but she was not uttering the words. It was a private prayer between her and the Lord. And the Eli looked at her and thought that she had gone into a state of drunkenness and was just making a fool of herself, when in reality she was expressing herself with such great desire that she was pouring her heart out unto the Lord. And here's what happened as a result of it. We find that Hannah prayed and she was pouring out her soul to the Lord in verse 15. And it says in verse 16, I've been praying here out of the great anguish and of the grief. You know, whenever it is that we're in a state of great anguish and grief, what we need to do is pray to the Lord, to the point that the Holy Spirit takes over and expresses our desires to God and leave it before him. Because one of the things we find about Hannah when she left the temple that day, or when she left the church that day, she left a different woman because she had given it over to the Lord. And as a result of that, we find that God blessed her and answered her prayer. Now, I don't know that God would do that for you, because I don't know what God has planned for you. But I do know this, that if we find ourselves in a state of anguish over something in our life that is so much that it is changing our appearance and people are looking upon us wondering what's wrong, that would be a good time to go to the Lord and just pour out our heart to the Lord in anguish, so that God can have that opportunity to answer that prayer. And we pray that he will. It worked for Hannah. I pray it'll work for you.